follow along if you want and submit issues for everything that I've done wrong. But yeah, just feel free to look around. So this is this project. Can you everybody like see my screen and read properly more or less, or is it too small? So this is like the standard architecture I use generally. So we're going to start by build task folder. So myself, I use npm scripts to orchestrate everything in my Eleventy projects. The other school of thought is to use Eleventy to orchestrate everything. I generally rely on npm script to do it. And sometimes I need a bit more than a one and a CLI to do what I want to do, to bend the web to my will. And so in those cases, I use more involved like build task or node script. In this case, it's a little script I wrote to transform all my images, so to generate the thumbnails. I could have used Eleventy images, but the problem with it is that it has a limitation that it doesn't allow you to crop images, at least when I made this website, and I believe it's still the case now. So this is a little website using Sharp, which is the same library that Zach used to develop by Eleventy image. And yeah, it's a fairly simple script, but that generates all my images at build time and I can use it. So that's build task folder for you. That's what I use to have a bit more like involved script should I need them. Then we come up to the heart of early Eleventy website, which is the Eleventy.js config file. So my goal for that was to have something as clean as possible. I noticed after doing like a few projects that I tend to structure this file a bit differently. It gets messy pretty quickly. So my goal here was to have something that is really clear and readable. Every collection, shortcode, filter, transform, etc. Basically requires a file. And dependencies are required in those files, which allow me just to require those files at the top of the file and then have something very, very simple and clean and readable. And also I can reuse a lot of things like, I don't know, date filters, for example, which is something I reuse from project to project. I can just like require a date and then a date file with all my filters in there and then do it. I've seen a lot of people doing, you know, a bit more like automated setup for this kind of thing, but I like it like this. It's a kind of middle ground between things being crawled and applied and something that is a bit more explicit. So this one is a bit more explicit. This is generally how I do it. Then we can move to the source folder, and I basically have all those six folders in there always. So I'm going to start from the bottom. This is a convention that I've seen in other static site generator like Yugo, for example. So it's a static folder. Generally, it contains everything that needs to be at the root of my dist folder of the generated website. So things like your robot.txt, something like your icons, your fav icons, etc. They all go in there, and basically I'm using add pass through copy with the object notation just to bang it in the dist folder. So that's fairly standard convention I've borrowed from other static site generators I've worked with in the past. But most importantly is the content folder, which contains everything in terms of content, be it markdown files for your collections, be it templates and things like this. And for multilingual websites, I tend to start with a top folder, which is the locale of the different locales or languages that I'm using on the site. And it starts with an Eleventy data file that works with the folder. So it's a folder data file, and it sets the locale for everything that will be in that folder. After that is a bit more freeform, depending on the type of content. Well, here I have a pages website, which directory, which is all the pages in there. Then the links, which is markdown files, and books, which is also like full of markdown files. I've standardized on JS files for Eleventy data files because they're a bit more powerful and you can insert a bit of logic in there. And I use them in a nested way very often. So for example, in the links here, I've got nested things in there, nested data files. So I can basically set a type and an order for different things and have the things actually displayed in the order I want them to be displayed in. I will come back to that later on, but that's essentially the content folder that I use in every project. Next up, we have assets. So here the treatment is a bit different depending on the types of assets I'm dealing with. So fonts, for example, are optimized and then I just copy them to the dist folder. Same goes with images as well. And those are the images from which all the thumbnails are created by the script I presented earlier on. So those are just copied. For JS, I use ES Build because it's really, really fast. And I generally don't need like a massive pipeline, JS pipeline. So ES Build does pretty much anything that I needed to do. And so this is processed, ignored by Eleventy, processed and banged into the dist folder. And in this case, I've got two bundles that are made, a main one and one containing just the app. I'm going to come back to that later on as well. And then there is a SCSS folder which contains my SAS that is also like handled and compiled via an NPM script and then put into my dist folder as well. So those are fairly static and standard folders. Then we move to includes. I'm an Unjux person, and so my layout and macros and things like this are in this include folder. They have to be. I start with an SVG folder. So this contains all my icons and logos and things like this. It allows me to include them via Unjux. I think a lot of you guys are doing that as well. It allows you to put a bit of logic if you have to inject some CSS classes in there and things like this into your SVG. It's nice to have them as includes. Partials, they are my dumb component. By dumb, I mean that those are components that only need to have access to what Unjux call like the global context. Global template context, which is like global variables. Basically, they are components to which I don't need to pass props or variables in any way. So things like the foot pagination interface, the main navigation, for example, is dealt with those partials. So here is, for example, the one for the main navigation. So not the languages one, but just like the normal navigation in there. And as you can see, it only has access to the global context and does nothing very special. However, I use this locale variable there so I can reference localized content in there. So for example, my navigation here uses the main nav JS file here, which uses a nested object struct, and using that locale that is the same as the code here, as the key here, I can display my translation for the navigation without any problem and in a very flexible and standard way. So that's for partials, basically dumb component outputting a lot of HTML and just using the global template context. I'll come back to that template context a bit later on as well. Then we come to macros. Macros are my go-to for when I need a bit of a simple logic, when I need props, and when our properties or variables passed to that component. And if they're generally repeated pieces of content, like the prototypical component to which I can pass props. And I think Unjux macros are really, really good for this. You need to declare them explicitly, but you can pass them properties in a really, really easy way. And they're quite good at outputting a whole lot of HTML, like when you have to do responsive images and switching between WebP and JPEG and this kind of stuff. And they're very, very simple to use. So if we go into one of the page and look at like a book component or something like this. So there you go. You just declare your component at the top of the page. So here, you just declare it. And then you can use it like you would in a lot of other contexts. So people using like things like next and next and things like this are very familiar with this. So it's the Unjux equivalent. That's generally why before I reach for shortcode, etc. My philosophy is to use everything the template language offers me, and only after that, only if I cannot do it with macros, I will move to shortcode. So typically I move to shortcodes when I need node NPM packages or advanced logic or things like this. But generally for the main components of a project, I will work with Nunchucks macros because that's the way I usually do, is try to first use what the templating language of your choosing has to offer. Then we can move to layouts. Here again, keeping in line with this philosophy, I mainly use Nunchucks templates and layouts. They have a mechanism called template inheritance, which allows you to use blocks that you can override with child templates. So in my opinion, it's a fairly superior mechanism to what Eleventy offers. Eleventy is great. Eleventy layout mechanism is great. It's very simple. And I use it, for example, in markdown files most of the time. But I use it to reference a Nunchucks template, and then I'll fall back to this inheritance mechanism. So as I said, this allows you to use blocks. You can easily override those blocks. And for example, this block is a little block at the end of my head, and I use it to inject the petite view script for the database portion of the website, just for that page. So if you look again at the science page here, I've got a little block, and I just include one of the, not the main bundle of the site that is included in the main template, but just this one that I need. So it allows me to create like little apps for the pages that need them. And I don't build a lot of fully featured with Eleventy. I build a more or less content-oriented website or things of that nature, or little hybrids like the one I've built here. And it fits the build perfectly. I mean, you can use alpine.js, you can use Petite View in that fashion. And basically you just build, or I just build like a little app for the page where I need it, which allows it to be self-contained and not to, you know, overblown your main bundle with something that you will only need on one page. So that's the layout mechanism I use. I really, really use extensively these Nunchucks layouts. So next I have a data folder that's fairly standard in the Eleventy world or in the Eleventy community. The only specific thing here is that since it's a multilingual website, I will use those locale keys everywhere that I need translations, to be able to actually fetch the right strings from those data files. And if I have to do something with a database, as it is the case here, so the database here, for example, for the type here, will output different things if you're in French or English and things like this. And so this is what I do as well for this kind of stuff. Then in terms of translation, sometimes you have some odd little pieces of content, little strings that need translation. And for that, I will use a filter, and I will come back to that, and kind of dictionaries like this that allows me to translate, in this case, from French to English very easily. And that's how we come to this last folder, which is the _Eleventy folder. It's something I've seen in a lot of places, and I try to be very systematic about it. Every collection is a function in there, every filter as well, things like this. So you have very, very simple collections, like the books here that are very, very simple collections. And sometimes you need things that are a bit more involved. So we talked about the ordering the links by types here. So that's what you have here, for example. So they're all by a certain type, and those types are ordered in a certain way, in the way the client wants them to be ordered. So it's a bit more involved of a collection, and I use a Lodash in here. It just keeps things very, very tight and very tidy. You just require what you need as packages on top of that, and then you can make your collections. Same goes for filters. In this case, a very, very simple one, like a limit filter, essentially just slicing an array in there. And sometimes I group things in a file. So all my dates filters, for example, are in one file that most of them use Luxon. They all require it. And then in my Eleventy folder, I just require them in a separate. So basically you can either do this or you can require one file and then just call it every time in there. Voila, so this is how I generally do it. I wanted to talk about this because it really, really changed my way of working. So I really like the way Eleventy doesn't force you to work in such and such way, but it was really, really beneficial for me to develop a standard way of working and to be able to move more quickly from project to project, to when I was working with a friend or with a colleague, to be able to onboard them easily on what I've done, and a set of conventions like this, I think, is very, very nice to have. So I really don't want you to adopt my way of working in any way, but I just hope that talking about this will trigger you to do something, if you're not already, about creating your own little standard project structure. There you go. I think I'm done. Thank you very much for listening. And if anybody has questions or remarks or whatever, I'm all ears.